Hi guys, welcome to the stream. How are you guys doing? Hope you guys are having a good day. Ba ba ba. We are here today to do Baiju summons, wishes for Dr. Baiju. It's been a long time coming, and of course, this is also going to become a video for the YouTube channel. So. I'm gonna go through that as well, but yeah, just wanted to give a minute for you guys to have a chance to show up, and I'm gonna finish setting things up. Let me know if the volume's okay. I'm trying something a little different with the audio this time. I'm trying to record the background music along with the video file, just so that you guys aren't sitting here for 30 minutes in silence with just me talking. So let me know if the volume sounds okay. All right, there we go. Yeah, I hope you guys are all having a good day. And just a minute, we're gonna start, and I'm gonna restart the music so that it goes along with. Really brought me around on him. He ended up becoming a character that I think is actually pretty cool. He's not my favorite by any means, but he went from one of my least liked characters in the entire game to one that I think is actually pretty dang cool. And he also works really well with Sino, who is one of my favorites. So I felt like it was finally time to get him. I almost pulled on his initial banner about a year ago when he had Kaveh. But I decided to hold off. I was saving for Linny, wanted to make sure I was able to get everything I wanted for Linny. And also, I wasn't 100% sure if I was just kind of fooling myself into thinking I wanted Baiju, and really I just wanted Kaveh. But as time has passed, playing Baiju in events with Sino and everything, I've kind of come around to it, and I decided, yeah, I do want him. And now that I finally have the wishes to spare, we're gonna pick him up. His banner's also not the best for me. I already have C6 Beidou, and I don't really care much for Layla, but it does have Faruzan, and I'm missing, I think, two Faruzan constellations, so having the chance to potentially pick her up here is also really good. And yeah, we have 269 wishes for the doctor.
Nice.
So we're going to bring him home. Hopefully, I don't have to. I've got mixed feelings. I want Baiju early, but I also really want those two Faruzans. So, hopefully, we get her as well. Getting her to C6 and finally being able to use my Wanderer over here would be very nice. But we're gonna see what we can get from this, and hopefully, it goes well. Dr. Baiju, I need you to come home. That is, that's a, I have an illness. Make a house call, please. All right, let's go ahead and start the first 10 pull. Let's go. Rally luck. We want to see Faruzan, or like an off-banner Kaveh, or Gaming. Gaming would also be great. I want Gaming cons like the most right now. I think that's my most wanted 4-star cons for the boy. So, starting things off, just a Layla. Okay. Not the most exciting. Oh, and an off focus Fischl. Okay, cool. So two 4-stars to open is pretty nice. Sadly, neither of them are ones that I really like that much or have much use for. But cool. Actually, huh. I thought I had C6 Fischl already, but I guess not. I haven't ever finished building her. I kind of started back during the summer event that included her. I started building her, and then I just kind of got bored of it when I think Dendro came out right after that, and everyone else was excited for her, but I was just like, eh, I'm getting Sino, so I've already got an Electro that I can play. So, yeah, I lost a little bit of interest there. I still don't have her built, but I thought I had her C6'd at least, but apparently not, so cool. Alright, so that was pull. That was our first 10 pull. Here's our second. Come on. Madam Faruzan, please grace us with your presence. Another Layla, okay. She's... I don't know about more valuable, but she is pretty valuable since she is still fairly new. But I just don't really have an interest in building her. I have Xiongli. And I've also got like Toma as a shielder if I want him. But usually I just... and we're going to get Baiju as well, so that's another shielder. But normally, in most instances, I'm usually good with either Xiongli or Xingqiu. And then Baiju, specifically for Sino, is what I want him for. But I'm not sure where I would really play Layla. But I guess the constellations for her are okay. And that's the last of our stockpiled Acquaint Fates. But we still have plenty of Primos left. I also have a lot of Fontaine exploration I've been putting off, and also like half of Chenyu Vale. So I can definitely get more wishes after this for Farina. And there's our Faruzan! Yay! Madam Faruzan, excuse me. We must address her with her appropriate title. But I think that brings us to C5 on her, which is wonderful. Again, I really want to be able to use my Wanderer that I bought, that I pulled for like a year and a half ago. He barely sees use just because his damage is like okay, but it's not like spectacular. And C6 Faruzan should be able to help with that a bit. Alright, so that's one. Again, I think I need just one more copy of her. This is our fourth pull. Alright, one more Faruzan, please. If we get... Oh, a Dragon's Bane. Okay. That's not too helpful. I have a lot of those. But if we get the C6 Faruzan, then we want to hope that we get Baiju really quick after that. But if we don't get Faruzan, I'm actually okay with losing the 50-50. Ideally to Tenari or Dea. Even though Chi-Chi is... Dr. Baiju's assistant, we're kind of hoping she doesn't show up. I've seen her enough recently. Alright. Batch number 5. Another Layla. Okay. That's not Madam Faruzan. I swear there's always one... Where'd our music go? Oh, it's just buffering. I'm gonna wait for the music to come back. Hold on. Where'd our music go? Okay, there it is. what was I saying? It feels like there's always like one 4-star. It cut out again. It feels like there's always one 4-star on the lineup that just isn't there, that isn't present. Here. If it's gonna do that, I'm gonna just restart the music then. I'll restart it manually. There we go. But yeah, it feels like there's always one 4-star that just feels more rare on the banner than the others, and it feels like there's one that's more common and then there's one that's just kind of average. It feels like this time it's Beto who's just not showing up, and then Faruzan is the average one. And Layla's super common for me, apparently. tends to be the less ideal of the batch, it seems. I would definitely rather have Beto cons than Layla cons, just because Beto gives more Star Glitter back. But at this rate, soon Layla will be giving full Star Glitter as well, I guess. Actually, was that... we didn't get Star Glitter for that one? Was that... Wait. I wasn't paying attention. Maybe we did get Star Glitter and I just didn't notice. I was like, wait, did we just get her maxed out? Wait, yeah, if she was maxed out, we would be still getting Star Glitter, so I probably just wasn't paying attention. Anyway, anything else in this batch that's interesting? A second Layla. Okay, wow. Okay, so... Five of Layla's Stella Fortunas. Wow. I think they were all from just this session, so... Well, yeah, because I would have activated them already. Alright, come on. One Faruzan, please. Oh my goodness. Oops, all Layla. All Layla. Where is Madame Faruzan? Did she get trapped in the ruins again? Oh no. We have to save her. We must conduct an expedition to rescue Madame Faruzan. It's, bad. I was keeping track decently, and I think that was 70 pulls, but I don't remember, so I'm gonna have to calculate it myself in the video itself, which is not great. Hi, Unknown, welcome to the stream. Not good. The luck is not good. We just got pity broken, unfortunately. We're still missing one Faruzan for our Wanderer, and we have gotten like 5 or 6 Laylas, and that's pretty much it. Well, we got one Faruzan. That's the best thing we pulled this entire batch after like 70 wishes was one Faruzan. Cursed pulls. Again, this has not been my year. This year has not been my year. Oh, Cap'n Beto. I like Cap'n Beto. She doesn't do anything for us, but I like her. She gives us wishes back, so that's actually... I like that more than Layla, because we get more Star Glitter than before. Summon for the Mew Mew instead? No, I already have him. I already have him. Kabuki Meow Meow is already home. Come on, Madame Faruzan. Yeah, 5 wishes from Cap'n Beto is more valuable to me than 5 Layla constellations. Alright, next batch. Come on. Madame Faruzan. Yes! Madame Faruzan! There we go. I think that makes her C6. I'm not 100% sure, but I'm fairly sure that she was C4 already. We're up to 32 Star Glitter. I did redeem all the Star Glitter I had before I started this as well. But now we just need to get Dr. Baiju himself. Hopefully he comes fairly quick now. And the units we want are either Faruzan Beto for more Star Glitter or like an off-focus Gaming or Kaveh. Or Chevres, I guess. She would also be pretty cool. Fremenet or Chongyun, I think I'm also missing cons on. And Mika as well, but Star Glitter's good. But yeah, Dr. Baiju, not my favorite character. His design is also not my favorite. He's kind of ugly sometimes. I go back and forth. Like, I see the appeal behind him, but like, he's not really a character for me. But he did grow on me a little. Yeah, that's cool. I think I already had his C4, which is like his most important con. So everything after that, I just kind of didn't care much. Not a fan of the crop top. Fair. I could rock it, though. I could rock it. Alright, come on. Something else cool in here. Another Layla, okay. Well, I mean, she's cryo, so I guess she's technically cool. Come on, Dr. Baiju. Hurry. No, it's still no gold. I'd rock it better than him, thank you. Another Faruzan. Okay, well, this will tell us for sure if I was still missing constellations or not. I'm pretty sure that I already had her C6 from the last two, but we'll see. I might have miscounted. I didn't actually check before we started this because I was too lazy to open the menu. So I last checked like 2 weeks ago when the banners got announced and she was here. Alright, where we should be close to Pity again. Nope. Cap'n Beto, once more. Another Cap'n Beto. Well, she made up for not showing up earlier on. She decided to just pop up double. And here he is.
I am Baiju, a practitioner of medicine at Boo Boo Pharmacy. So, are you experiencing any discomfort?
Yes.
If so, where? And
my
how
heart.
Many days have the symptoms persisted?
5 months.
Hmm? You don't require medical attention?
No, I do.
Oh, so you came to see me. Ah, then I'm sorry. I'm afraid I must ask you to wait. I'd like to see the other patients first before discussing things any further.
Rude. Anyway, we got him, so that's nice. Double Beto with two rounds of Star Glitter. So there we go. Got Layla Stella Fortuna. And, yeah, where is he? He should be right there. There he is. Dr. Baiju. Yeah, again, not my favorite design, but pretty cool character, and he will be very helpful for my wonderful Sino so that he stops getting ping-ponged every time an enemy looks at him. So I'm excited about that. Real quick, let's also take a look. We got Kuching as well. We got... How many Laylas? Did we get her all the way to C6? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Yes, we did max out Layla. I know her C1 is pretty important, but I don't know about the other ones. And then... We got... Oh, that was Fischl's C6 that we got randomly. So that's cool. I guess if I ever decide I do want to play Fischl, but so far I haven't had much interest. Is she actually good with Sino? I don't know. Oh, that was Toma's C6 as well. Nice. Burning Heart for our big-hearted boy. We got Madame Faruzan, C3... C4 and C6. So she wasn't C4 like I thought. She was only C3. So that last one was actually important to getting the C6. But now we can actually play our Wanderer, so that's going to be great. And then the last thing we got were Betocons, who was already C6. So that doesn't do anything for us. But here we go, Dr. Baiju. And we got everything I wanted off that banner. Again, the off-focus was not who I was hoping to see. I really wanted Dia or Tenari, but I can't complain too much given that we got the C6 Toma, the C6 Faruzan, and the Baiju. So overall, very good pulls. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, joining me for another wishing session, and until next time, this is Hoodie Angel Brandon and Dr. Baiju signing out. Okay. So, hold on. I'm gonna turn off the music now. And I'll turn on regular music. I was in the middle of talking, so I didn't respond, but Morph, you got freaked out by him talking. That was a thing they added a few patches ago. Where now when you pull a character, they actually say their introduction line. So it's kind of cool. And I wanted to let them do their little speech. They only say it the first time you pull them, though. So Kuching also did her speech, but then everyone else I pulled was a duplicate, so they didn't say anything. Let me see. Music. There we go. So, we can also add him to the party lineup. Gaming and Cloud Retainer, probably kind of a weird choice for pulling for Baiju, but we're actually going with this team for exploring the rest of Chenyu Vale. That's why they were there. Where is he? Dr. Baiju, where'd you go? Oh, is he down here because he's low level? Yeah, there he is. There he is. Kind of a basic pose, but it fits him, I guess.
Time for a house call.
Thank you, Doctor. Oh no, the stream wasn't over. I was just, I wanted to end the segment for YouTube. I wanted to record the, that's going to become a fully edited video for YouTube, so I was just doing the outro for that so that I don't have to record that on my own later. We also recorded the intro. But, yeah, I guess we need to... Alright. So, Morph, if you don't like Baiju, the optimal way to punish him is to just play him, because every time you run, he just starts dying. Well, maybe not every time you run, but like when you run, he can just start coughing and dying. There he goes. Oh man, gotta change his wings too. But yeah, we gotta build him. I did pre-farm for him. I actually pre-farmed for him back when I was debating pulling him with Kaveh. So like, I just kind of had resin to spend, and I didn't want to... I was so burnt out on farming domains, I was just dumping it anywhere I could. I think I farmed for some other characters back then. Like, I pre-farmed Daya as well, even though I still haven't gotten her. So I just pre-farmed a bunch of characters just to burn off resin that I didn't want to use. I'm stuck. But, yeah... we're also going to do artifact domain or artifact run, artifact strongboxing today, and also maybe doing some. I haven't done my dailies yet, actually, so probably those, and there's this. What is it? Overflowing Mastery, right? Gotta farm prosperity books? What does Baiju use, actually? I don't know what books he needs. Grandpa needs his meds? Yeah. Is he grandpa-coded? I don't know that Baiju is grandpa-coded. I think he reads more of, like, flamboyant uncle. I think that's what Baiju reads to me. He's more like an uncle. Chat is very delayed. I'm sorry. Yeah. Stream is giving issues sometimes, so I try not to worry about it too much. But I guess we should level him up, right? That'd probably help. Go to 18. Oop, I wasn't done. Press the wrong button. How much? 4,000. No, thank you. Sure.
Everything must take its due course. No need to be impatient.
And, we'll do another batch of those. That. 675, more than needed. Yeah, sure.
Thanks.
Oh, I didn't hear what he was saying. Hold on. What were you saying, my guy? I'm sorry, I interrupted you.
Thanks to your hard work, I think I'm feeling stronger than ever.
Okay. All right. I'm gonna have more 900 more of that no matter what. Okay. So yeah, we just gotta level him up. Oh, that's too much. I don't wanna burn that much extra experience. How am I gonna build him? Standard. I think he only has like one real build, and then, well, I guess you can play him what, Deepwood? I think you can technically give him Tenacity of the Millilith, but I don't think he's very good at it. And I guess you can also run Noblesse on him, or like Instructor, if you already have a Deepwood user on the team, but usually he's best with Deepwood, from what I recall. So, real quick, actually, we could, before we finish leveling him, we can give him his stuff. I already gave his artifacts. Hold on. Who's holding his artifacts? Aloy has his artifacts. Okay. They're all Deepwood pieces. Okay. So, we're going to go here. And let's sort. Deepwood memories. Yeah. Artifact recommended is Deepwood. So we're just going to go through and... I haven't finished leveling his sands yet. But here's his goblet. HP percent goblet with a lot of ER. Those are the main things he really wants. Unless you're running Favonius Codex. In which case he does want to build some crit rate. But otherwise he mostly just wants HP, ER, and flat HP. He can run a healing bonus circlet or a HP circlet. I don't remember which one's actually better for him. I think healing bonus is better if you're running him with Farina. And otherwise he's better with HP circlet. I've got this, good healing bonus circlet with, 25% HP still, so I was gonna run with that, but I think I think it kind of depends on which team you want to run him with, but since I'm planning to pick up Farina, I figured I'd just give him a healing bonus circlet anyway. And then let's see, we've got this flower with, and 41% ER from artifacts. And for his weapon, I want to make him another prototype amber. I think he can run prototype amber, sac frags, Favonius Codex. I don't know if you can run Thrilling Tales on him, but that's another option. We could just run Thrilling Tales, but the main thing is he wants a lot of energy recharge, so prototype amber is really helpful because it gives him, it doesn't give him energy recharge, but it does give him energy back as a refund, so that's very helpful for him. I guess we could just borrow it from Yanfei, but like, see, he's already got 28k and he's not even fully leveled and everything. 141 ER, and yeah, we still need to level his artifacts too, so we'll go ahead and finish that. Actually, I don't know if I have the artifacts to level all these right now. I've been running out of artifacts, actually, low level ones for fodder. Let's see, hoping for ER more than anything on this. ER, please. No. ER, please. Bah. See, this crit rate would be good if I wanted to run him on Favonius Codex, but I'm not particularly interested in running him with that. The attack percent is just kind of useless all around, but... And I'm out of consumables, see. Yeah, I've got a lot of artifacts, but not low-level ones. So he's going to be a bit of a work in progress. I don't have everything fully finished for him, but I can grab these. An Acquaint Fate, and another Acquaint Fate. Don't die on me, dude. Oh,
it's just some chronic problem I have flaring up again. Nothing to worry about.
Don't die. I'm at 243 Acquaint Fates, wow. Insane behavior. Let's see. So we can't do any more with the artifacts just because I'm out of fodder. And... Yeah, we can just level him up normally with that. How do we want to go about doing... Okay, that's still not ready. We could take him to do some domains, I guess. I don't think that Sino will be good for that domain, though. Well, I still want to kind of see him. A gust of wind could kill him? Yeah, probably. Where is my Sino team? I don't remember why I had Venti here, but let's get Dr. Baiju in here.
Time for a house call.
There we go. Alright, so I guess we also need to do dailies, but I don't want to do those. I'd rather go hunt for chests, honestly. But first, should do, let's see, where is it? Where's the domain here? There we go. It's Prosperity Day. Oh yeah, I was gonna check what talent book Baiju needs. I don't remember. I forgot. I forgot. What books do you need, my guy? No, not you. Gold. Ooh. Gold books. Well, today's not gold day, so we can't grind for those. today's prosperity day for Gaming. So we're going to grind those instead. But this isn't going to be ideal. This isn't a domain that I would normally use Sino in. And also, Baiju isn't like fully built, but we'll test him a little bit with what little he's built for. Yeah, I'm not sure if I should make a second prototype Amber for Baiju. I have the billets for it, honestly. Like, look at this nonsense. I've got 3 Northlander billet troves. Oh, lagged a little bit. And then 4 Northlander Catalyst billets. So I can make him his own rank 5 prototype Amber if I want. I'm not sure if I should, but it's not like I'm using Northlander billets for anything else. They're kind of useless, so. Oh, Sino's dead. Why is he dead? Should go to the Mondstadt talent domain for fun? You have an interesting idea of fun.
Germinate! Propagate!
Actually, the funny thing is, everyone complains about the Mondstadt talent domain. I don't think it's as bad as people say it is.
My judgment.
Oh, Sino just died. I think Sino ran into the blooms right as they procced, and he died. Rip. Rip my mans.
Rain. No, my sword. Rain cutter.
Yeah, I think as he slid into the blooms, they exploded normally before he could trigger Hyper Bloom. So they exploded on him and then he died. Still cleared that domain really easily without that. But that's what I was saying. I don't think Mondstadt Talent Domain is as bad as people say. I think people are just too stubborn to use units that are good in it. Like, I ran a team with Kazuha, Toma, Xiangling, and Bennett, and it shreds that domain, like, really easy. It's really not that bad. But yeah, we're gonna use our daily resin double ups from the event. No golds. And then we'll do some dailies, and we can also do weekly bosses reset today, didn't they? We could also do those. Hold on, let me just check that. I'm pretty sure, right? I don't know, do you guys want to see me do the weekly bosses? I don't know, it'll spoil some things for some of you if you haven't seen it yet. Hold on, I forgot to actually look at what I was looking for. Yeah, the weekly domains reset, so we can do those.
Here, spring forth!
Rain outlines your fate. Let me weave you a verse.
Mind the side effects. Taking a turn for the better.
The doctor will see you.
This is nothing.
You haven't been to a pep. Yeah, I was. The three I was gonna do are the three most recent ones, which are the two Fontaine ones and the one from Sumeru. So I don't know if people want me to show that or not. It would be spoilers for some of you guys.
Mind the side effects.
Oh my goodness, Sino died again. Get him, doctor. Sino died again. Oops. He died before the healing went through, unfortunately. Unknown is fine with me doing them. I don't know, Oofj, I know you haven't done all of the weekly stuff. Do you care, or do you want me to not spoil that? Also, we just finished the battle pass, so yay. a little slower than I usually finish them, but still pretty ahead of schedule. Sino craves death. His penance is due. Nah, I'm sad. I want Sino to come back. I'm going to wait because I want to revive Sino. You can look away for a few minutes. Okay. Yeah, I do want to do those domains just because I think it'd be cool to do them on stream. Well, one of the Fontaine domains, honestly, well, I call them domains, but I guess they're Trounce domains, whatever. One of the Fontaine bosses I think is lame as hell, but the other one is really cool, so I want to show that one. It's the most recent one, the most spoilery one, but yeah, I think the Fontaine domain, or the Fontaine Trounce domains, one of them is just really lame, personally, but come on. Hurry up, I want to bring back Sino. I want to actually play him with Baiju. Come back to us. There we go. Nope. I'm going to just stuff him full of food so he doesn't instantly die and Baiju has a chance to actually heal him later. There we go. Let me think. Is Baiju gonna be... Yeah, Baiju's gonna be too weak to bring into the boss domains, unfortunately. So we won't be able to show him off there. He's just not built enough for it, but... I have other teams for those. Kind of. A Pep is, like, the most annoying one because it's just very slow. Even bringing Venti doesn't speed it up as much as I would hope it would. I need to learn the rotation, including Baiju, though. I don't know what the ideal rotation is.
Remember, health comes first.
Sino, don't die. Sino, don't die.
Rain cutter.
Scatter.
By the time Sino's burst was ready, it wasn't worth it to use. It would have just, he would have done like two attacks and then it would have been done, and there's no point using the burst for that. But there we go, that uses all of our daily double ups from the event. Yay! Oh, we finally got a gold one. Nice. Okay, so that takes care of that. Yeah, I guess we'll run to do those, the weekly domains real quick, and then we'll start strongboxing, probably. We'll move on to the strongbox. Huzzah! Yeah, we used all those. Let me think. I wanna start with the newest domain. So we'll start here, just because I think this one's the coolest, so I'm more eager to do it than the other ones. The other two domains, I'm not very excited about those boss fights. I'm just like, oh, cool. So, is my crystal flytrap done? No, I don't want that. Not finished, okay. Also, hold up. I almost forgot. Is my thing done? 31 minutes until my parametric transformer is done, so can't do that yet. But let's do this one. We're gonna swap our team. Sure. Actually, I do kind of want to bring Baiju for this. I don't think Beto really helps on this team or this fight much.
Hopefully, this won't take long.
Don't back sass me, dude. So, yeah, we're going to do this fight just because I think it's cool. Well, not just because I think it's cool. We're going to do this fight first because I think it's cool. We're also going to do it just because I need to do it this week anyway, so... I'm still not particularly great at this fight, though. It's a little tricky. I'm probably not bringing the best team for it, but this is the team that I've liked running in this fight the most so far, so.
Afraid? Or do you not even have the courage to be afraid? Right here. Is it my turn now?
I hear everything.
Emerge now, right now. With these rising flames, is it my turn now?
One with the forest.
Spare your energy. Running is of little use.
I'm not running. I'm hanging back and sniping.
Right here.
Have
right
a taste
now.
Of purgatory.
Hold the line.
Mind the side effects. Taking a turn for the better.
And shroud
with these rising flames.
I'll uproot you.
Show it.
Okay.
Right here.
Go Yai.
Allow me.
Yai's energy is very much not going as fast without Beto.
Look at this. Can't see. Trapped like a bunch of helpless animals.
My tails are messed up.
Show them right now.
And again, like, this probably isn't the ideal team for this, but.
Hold the line.
Flowers have...
Bye, Tanari. Baiju, burst.
Show them.
Look, one with the forest.
Trapped like a bunch of helpless animals.
Yeah.
Is it my turn now?
There we go. Phase one done. Again, like, this isn't the ideal team for this, but I like this team for this fight. It's kind of fun. This cutscene's really cool. She's so cool. I still kind of want to pull for her, even though I don't really need her. Okay. Kokomi just immediately eats it.
My blade is all
right
that
now.
Remains.
Emerge.
Can't see? Buried. Let's nip that in the butt.
Oh, Kokomi just got hit with a laser. Wow, this is actually going a lot faster with Baiju than it did with Beto. Even my unleveled Baiju, he's like helping make this a little smoother. The trade-off is, the trade-off was Yai's energy wasn't recharging quite as fast, but, that was definitely more comfortable. With Beto, I usually die a few more times than that. So, Baiju did make that a lot more comfortable. For only being, what, level 59, I think? Pretty good. Pretty good. So that's our first boss taken care of. Bad. Bad gladiator piece, but we did get a dream solvent, so nifty. How many do I have? I don't know if I've ever used a single one of my dream solvents, actually. I think I might have never used one. three and four. Okay. So there was that. That was that boss. Pretty fast. At least compared to my usual clears of that one. Ba-ba-ba. Do we do the other Fontaine one next, or do we do a Pep? I should do a Pep next, I think, just because that one's more tedious. I like that one a little bit less in terms of the actual fight, so I should do that one next. Ugh. I'm so excited to get the next boss so that I can stop doing a pep. I only do the three most recent bosses nowadays because I don't benefit from grinding more Ajdaha mats. As much as I'd love to go fight Ajdaha, that's my favorite boss, but I just don't benefit from fighting him anymore, unfortunately. Okay, what do I want to bring for this? Swap out Xiongli for Kazuha.
Sounds good to me.
Sounds good to him. He's happy to join us, so we will take him up on his offer. And let's go ahead and go through this with Linny. Linny Monopyro, my beloved. I find it really funny that when I started the game, one of the biggest draws to me was the reaction system, and now I'm maining a team that does not do reactions. That's just how powerful Linny is, that he was able to make me overlook the fact that mono teams are not my usual interest. Oh shoot, Linny's dead too. Did I just leave everyone dead? What happened? Hold on, let me heal him up real quick. There you go. Alright, a pep. I don't like a pep's fight, but the music is pretty good, so there's that at least. Oh, Linny, onto the circle. Come back.
And voila.
There we go. That wasn't like a perfect rotation, but it worked.
The wind knows. Clouds high.
The birds call. Wind strider. That might be my favorite, I think that might be my favorite verse quote.
A round of applause.
Where are you? There you are.
Now disappear. Here comes the finale. And voila! One with nature. Fallen leaves adorn my night.
I'm going in! After I get into the fire, you're in too!
Step right up.
There we go. That was actually the fastest I think I've gotten through that phase. That phase right there is why I absolutely do not like this fight. That phase just feels like busy work. It just feels like there was no reason to include that phase, honestly. Thing gonna spawn there. Okay.
Teamwork is dream work.
Yeah, I like this music here. It feels very Xenoblade to me. And there we go. Linny cleared that like three shots. Good job. And that just leaves my least favorite least favorite boss conceptually, but I still think I have more fun fighting it than a pep, just because that middle phase is just so tedious. And that gives us another dream solvent, too. Cool. 149. Do I really need 149 dream solvents? No. But boy, I'm going to be able to triple crown the unknown god day one, right? Okay, so last of our weekly bosses, we're gonna go Fontaine Boss 1, the giant space flea from nowhere, my favorite trope. Yes, I do need them. I don't need them, no. I do not need 149 dream solvents. Do I still play the TCG? Genius Invocation TCG? Not really. I played it a few weeks ago, but I never like really played it like competitively. I mostly just did the in-game stuff. My least favorite boss, let's go. And we're actually going to swap out Kazuha. He doesn't help that much here. And we're going to take Grandpa with us. Come on.
What shall we do?
You gotta take a walk outside the retirement home. Let's go. Least favorite boss. Let's go. I just think this one's really dumb. It's not as tedious as a Peps fight, but it is really dumb. There you are. Also, this fight in particular is tricky for Linny because it's just easy to lose track of where the boss is. Because you're in charge shot mode. A little slow there.
Step right up. Let's get this show on the road.
Talking about Skara for a second? What? With what? I don't know what you mean. Why are we fighting this narwhal? That's a good question. They don't really tell you. They don't really tell you.
And voila.
Solidify.
Rip. Wasn't fast enough. It is technically possible to, it's possible to kill this boss before it goes to the second phase, but I've only managed to do it once. In fact, I'm not even sure if it was supposed to or if it was a glitch, honestly. If you told me it was a glitch, I'd believe you. There you are. Yeah, this phase is what makes this fight, like, really not fun. Like, I don't enjoy the fight already that much, but this phase here is just like, why? This makes no sense. I don't like it. There he is.
Nice and spicy.
Also, the music broke, so that's good. That's not my stream for once. The game just does this a lot.
I will have order.
And voila! Here comes the finale.
The boss is cool. Eh, I don't like it.
Stay calm.
And like, he breaks through Zhongli's shield really fast. I don't get it. Like, it should not be doing as much damage as it does.
Boba, get them!
Oh.
Solidify!
Everybody stand back! Let's light it up!
There we go, that was uneventful, and the music didn't play because the game broke, so good. Oh, now the music is going. Cool.
Rise.
And then in this fight, in this phase, like, after you clear that phase, it just sits there and it takes so much damage for no reason. It's, like, super weak at this section. There we go. That was very scuffed, but still took care of it, so whatever. I'm so confused. Yeah, that's how it goes in the story, too. That's how that section goes in the main story. It really makes very little sense. But there we go, that's all three of our weekly bosses done. Oh, wow. Baiju, I got you a new helmet. and two lightless Eye of the Maelstrom. Cool. No billets this week, unfortunately. Again, not that I really need them. I have more, these use a different billet than the gold ones, and I still have more than I could ever use of the new billets, too, so. Yay. Alright, is my crystal flytrap done yet? 12 more minutes on the parametric transformer. Wow, we did all of that in less in like 20 minutes? All three bosses in 20 minutes? That's actually pretty good. 2 hours and 11 minutes remaining on the crystal flytrap. Okay. Unfortunate. So I guess now we should go somewhere to burn our artifacts, yeah? Hold on, I'm gonna pull up my Google Doc with the artifacts that I'm looking for from, back. Alright, what are we looking for artifacts? Xiangling needs a new flower and a new helmet. Yai needs a new helmet and sands. Tenari needs a new flower. Sino is fine. Noblesse circlets for Benny, Mika, and Shenhe. Benny needs more crit. Mika needs a better healing bonus percent with more crit. And Shenhe needs attack percent with more crit. Okay. So I guess we'll go Noblesse. I'm gonna save these two here. So yeah, this is the less fun part where we just strongbox artifacts. Ooh, hold up. HP percent with ER, attack percent, crit rate? Hold on, is that like a cracked Baiju goblet, actually? Maybe. I guess I could save this. This could be good for Farina, actually. I can't run it because I'm running an off-piece Gilded Troop or Golden Troop helmet. Or I'm not running an on-piece Golden Troop helmet, so I'm running an off-piece there. But if I find an on-set Golden Troop helmet, then I could swap to this goblet, potentially. This could be a good Hydro Goblet, actually. I should hold on to that. See, this is the sad thing about strongboxing is I want to save every piece that I look at. I'm like, what if I need this later? Every time. EM and ER is actually a good combo for one. I should hold on to that. I'm so bad about this. I'm so bad about saving these. I should not be as much of a hoarder with them as I am. Hold up. Actually, this could be good for a DPS, I guess. Deepwood DPS. I guess that's not really a thing, but still. That one could be useful for, like, Baiju if it all rolls into ER and HP. I should hold on to this. Crit damage, HP, crit rate, and attack percent. Ugh. See, I keep looking at these, and I'm like, wait, this could actually be useful for someone. I'm so bad. Alright, attack sands, or attack circlets. I don't need those. Crit damage with crit rate could be okay. This one's HP with ER, which could be good for Baiju. HP, EM, ER. I'm so bad about burning these. But there we go, our first batch. Oh, and we'll confirm. Do we get anything cool? Attack goblet for noblesse. Attack with still bad stats. HP goblet for noblesse. EM, ER, that one's okay. Def percent? If this were a Mare Chaussee piece, this could maybe be good for Linny. no. Hold up. Actually, no. HP, HP, defense, defense. Not good for Mika. EM, crit, def, ER, def, HP. HP, attack, def, def. And attack, crit damage. Okay. Actually, you know, I kind of want to do... Well, no, because I do need a better circlet for Bennett. He needs more crit. Hold on. Let me actually check what Bennett's current circlet is, because I don't remember what we're working with. Okay, so he's got a crit rate circlet with 25 crit damage, and I think I need more than that? Jeez, okay. I don't know if I'm gonna beat that, honestly.
Wow. Where did that come from?
Am I sure that I needed a new circlet for Benny? Oh, wow. I forgot his circlet is actually cracked. What is this? Man, even Sing Cho, I feel like there's not a whole lot I can do to improve him. This Sans could be better slightly, but... If I swap him off of this sword in the future, then he does need a bit more ER. Because he's going to lose like 60%. So yeah, his Sans swapping to something with either ER main or attack main with more ER on it would probably be ideal. Everything else it's kind of hard to get improvements on, I think. Okay, Emblem of Severed Fates. Oh, well. EM circlet with no ER, I don't really care. Yeah, I've got a lot of EM circlets for this set, but they don't have good substats. Well, actually, hold on. No, it's flat attack, flat defense, and crit rate. Never mind. I was like, I guess technically, if I ever pulled Nahida, maybe I would want that, but no. These are bad even for Nahida, so. Healing bonus, HP, crit rate, crit damage, maybe. I'm still surprised they didn't do something like Farina converts healing bonus into damage or something. I think Kokomi has something like that, but still. This one would be cracked if that defense was HP percent instead. This would be like the god piece for Baiju. And let's go. I really wish we had Mare Chaussee in the strong box right now. That's what I want to farm the most. Def, bad. Attack EM def. ER EM def. Attack ER. ER crit rate attack percent. This one could maybe be something. It's not like perfect though. Crit rate EM. And then flat HP attack, that's bad. Crit damage ER attack. That's a little better, I think, but still not perfect. ER EM. That was a pretty bad batch. Maybe I do need to do Noblesse, though, because I don't know. I need Noblesse for Xiangling and Xingqiu, but I want to do Noblesse because I was thinking about swapping Aether to a Noblesse build now. EM, ER. Crit rate, crit damage. Sure. Maybe I'll go back and forth between them and see what I get from each, because I can't decide. HP goblet, attack goblet, attack goblet. EM crit damage, it's okay. Crit damage with crit rate and attack percent. This one's actually pretty okay. Crit rate EM ER. It could be useful as an off piece. ER crit damage, attack percent. That one's pretty good. And that one is doesn't have any ER, which for emblem I feel like is kind of important. If I want to go for Aether, what stats does he need? Let me check real quick. Dendro main character. I really wish the other travelers felt as nice and helpful as Dendro Traveler does. Alright, if we run Dendro Traveler with Noblesse. probably want attack sands, dendro damage goblet, or EM goblet, and then a crit rate, crit damage, or EM circlet. Okay. And ER crit damage, crit rate, attack, and EM. Okay. So, oh, why are we all the way down there? I don't know why it moved me to the bottom of there. I've got a lot of other stuff I want to strongbox, not my locked stuff. This one could be good, but eh. Ah, it is double crit. Okay. I'm much too indecisive for this. Truthfully, my fatal flaw. ER attack crit rate, that's pretty good actually. Same with this crit damage one. This one could be a this one's a double liner that could roll well. Ah, I keep saving all these. I'm supposed to be going through and getting rid of them, but okay. Hold up, this is actually a really good attack sand. This might be a good off piece, honestly. Hold on, actually I do like this one. One day I'm going to go through and clear up my locked artifacts too, but not today. Alright, show something cool. Nope, that's not it. Hydro with ER, attack percent, HP ER, HP crit damage, HP. Oh, if this was crit damage circlet, this would actually be really good, but HP percent, it doesn't help me. There we go. Hopefully it's back. You know, this could be good for Shenhe, maybe. Crit rate, crit damage, and defense. Flat. Yuck. Being better than Bennett's current circlet, this one could be good for Aether because HP. HP. Electro. Ooh. No, never mind. Bad. I feel like Electro Goblets are like my weakest set of goblets. Attack, crit damage, HP. Crit damage. Wait, was that attack percent? Yeah, okay. It's okay. Def percent. ER def def. Attack ER EM is okay. None of those were like particularly stellar though. Well, this one's a four liner with double crit. That one could just roll godly. Alright, all the cracked circlets I got. Crit rate with crit damage could actually be useful. EM crit rate, crit damage. Death percent with crit rate, crit damage would be great if I was running a Ito. But I'm not, so sadly it's worthless to me. Attack percent, no. Nope, and that's maxed. All right, HP, attack, attack. Oh, whoa, okay, we found the greatest circlet of all time. Look at this. Crit damage, crit rate, EM, ER. That could be really good. Even as just an off piece, I want to hold on to this. It might not roll well for Aether and Bennett because they kind of want more crit rate than crit damage, I feel. Especially Aether if he's running Favonius. But this could still be a fantastic off piece for someone. EM crit damage attack percent. This one could also be pretty good for like Aether. Crit damage ER. Yeah, not as exciting. Still two pretty good pieces in that set. No. ER. Some of these are just very silly circlets. Alright, anything else? EM Sands with, or EM Goblet with crit damage and attack percent. This could be really good for someone. I don't know what, maybe Tenari would want it? I'm not sure. Eepy. But someone could probably use an EM or EM Sands. Or EM Goblet, rather. Crit rate EM and HP. Yeah, nah. Healing bonus energy crit rate. If I want to play Healer Bennett. Pure Healer Bennett with Farina is apparently an actual thing. Another decent circlet with crit damage, crit rate, and ER. Again, I'd be a little more enthusiastic with crit rate as the main stat and crit damage as the sub, but still not bad. EM Sans with bad stats, and an attack Sans with bad stats and crit rate. Okay. Okie dokie. Double crit, sure. Hold on. Oh, no, flat attack. I thought that was attack percent. I was like, wait, why didn't I level this for Sino? Cryo, no. Physical, wow. Exactly what I was hoping to see. Ooh, hold up. ER, crit damage, and attack percent. That's pretty good. Yeah, if that rolls crit rate, that could be really good for, like, Bennett. EM, ER, but double defense is kind of whatever. HP, ER, EM, crit rate. That could actually be a good off piece for, like, Baiju if he doesn't get a better Sans. I should hold on to that. Man, this is a perfect def percent. Well, not perfect. I guess EM isn't as helpful for def percent Geo, but this could be pretty good. I should actually hold on to this in case we ever get a def scaling character I care about besides Albedo. Who's already built. I already built Albedo. If I get some cracked def-centric but golden troop pieces, though, I might re-kit my Albedo, honestly. Move Albedo to golden troop, and then someone else can just have his pretty good defense set for Husk of Opulent Dreams. Nope. ER crit rate is okay, but not, like, super exciting. Def, HP, ER crit damage EM on an HP Sans. It could be okay. It's not, like, amazing, but it could be useful for Baiju, potentially. He'd probably prefer crit rate than crit damage, though. Oh, and then we're up to Mare Chaussee. And then a lot of Noblesse. Yeah, I don't actually have that many artifacts left, actually. We've gone through a good chunk of them. And I'll do my Mare Chaussee pieces, but I think I might want to wait on Gilded Troop till I can look at them a little closer. Geo HP. Nah. Mario Chaussee is hard. Because they could release a lot of characters in the future that are actually good with Mario Chaussee. I should hold on to this one, actually. I don't have enough healing bonus circlets. And they could be useful. When I was looking for Baiju pieces, I was like, huh, I got rid of like all my healing bonus circlets and all my HP ones. That's no good. Crit rate, ER, attack percent. That one's actually pretty decent. ER, crit rate, eh. HP, no. Hold up, actually, really good Geo Goblet for all zero of my Geos. But who knows, maybe I'll get Navia eventually, and, well, I guess then she doesn't care about the death percent, so... Yeah, I'm still waiting on that death scaling Geo DPS, sadly. EM attack crit damage. That could be good for Aether. Actually, this could be good for Shenhe. This could be a really good Shenhe circlet. Oh wow, that's all our Mario Chaussee pieces already? I'll go through and clear the really bad golden troop pieces, but if I'm even like a little iffy on it, I'll probably save it because these could easily become more valuable in the future. I'm not loving any of these ones so far though. That one maybe. This one I don't want to save. Actually, this one's pretty good. I'll save that one. This one's really good. Hold on. Actually, this one could be a good Albedo piece, potentially. Because Albedo doesn't really care about his ER, if I recall correctly, because his burst is like a DPS loss. Okay, so I ended up actually trashing most of those golden troop pieces. I just don't really like them. I don't like either of those. Oh, well. Ba-ba-ba. Pyro. Eh. Physical. Oh, a double Dendro. That could be good for Aether. No. Yeah, nothing I really love in this batch. The goblet could be okay, but I'm not in love with it. Okay. Gladiator pieces. Not in love with these. Dendro with EM and crit damage could potentially be useful as a goblet. Geo, bad EM goblet, HP percent goblet, bad stats. And a pretty mid-def goblet, okay. ER, HP. Yeah, not loving these gladiator pieces. Double crit could be useful, though. Right now, I think the only character I would really consider running on gladiator is probably Arlecchino if I get her until I could farm a better set for her. Like, most of the other characters I'd want to build, I don't think really need gladiators, so I'm mostly looking at it through what would Arlecchino want if I pulled her. Not healing bonus. She might want crit rate. I'm not sure, I don't remember. I think she runs the risk of overcapping crit, though, actually. Hydro, bad. HP, crit rate, EM. That could be a pretty good onset goblet for Shenhe. Most of these aren't especially great, though. This HP goblet could maybe work for Farina, but she's on a offset circlet, so hard to... I hope the chat is back. This looks really good. This could be really good for someone. But, yeah, now we're pretty much caught up. It's just like the noblesse pieces to go through for the most part. So I think that's about where I want to call it. Chat's already, or the stream is already kind of breaking up, so. And I just did go a little bit later today, so I wanted to do a little bit of a shorter stream. So, yeah, the stream does not like me. It keeps disconnecting, so I'm going to call it here. Thank you guys for joining me. chat kind of died and everyone left or stopped talking anyway. So gonna call it here and see you guys next time. Bye-bye.